A couple months ago, I was on my Dell Precision laptop. And I was reading some articles on Jezebel.com. And I was learning stuff about white male patriarchy is institutionalized and how things are done here in America. And, well, as a flat cowboy, I just started feeling real guilty about this guy. All this time I thought I was being polite, but apparently every time I tip a cap to a lady, I'm reinforcing it, tell her never something called heteronormativity. I don't want to be reinforcing that. I'm just trying to be polite, going around, good folks, speaking to them. I sold my land, sold all my animals. And, just got stories now. I can't believe a cowgirl ain't paid the same amount as a cowboy. Cowgirls ain't paid the same amount. Now, I remember I was working on the bar restaurant ranch, and there's Ruth, and she was real hard. It just sickens me to my stomach to know that Ruby was paid less beans than us. I mean, we all got beans. 70% the amount of beans on her tin plate that I had. That makes me feel guilty. Before I left, I saw a cow looking at a horse. I don't know if this is actually real.
Remember, I invited you to
the cow was looking at a horse's butthole. Like through a barbed wire fence. See, I don't know if that's heteronormative. I'm trying to figure this out. God damn it, I'm just having to do it. Now, I can't tip the ladies no more. All I'm going to do is tip a cap to progressive social concepts. Now, here to help me break down the walls of white male opportunity. Good old roommate Dan. Y'all want to be my roommate Dan? Hey Dale, how's it going? I don't know, how's it going with you? I'm doing good. How was your day? My day's doing good. How was yours? I just had some corn. Oh, you had some corn, huh? I had some beans. Beans are better than corn. No, corn's better than beans. Beans. Corn. Beans. Keep corns. Beans. Yeah, see that, folks? We just can't get along all the time, but we're really good friends. We're roommates. Hey Dale, what else did you do today? I watched a porno. Porno? What's a porno? Well, porno is a video of people having sex. I'm not one of them. Well, that sounds like that's reinforcing the male, white male patriarchy heteronormativity. Really? It is? Alright, I'll stop watching porn. Alright, that's a good idea. No. That's good. That gentleman over there watch porn? That's rude. You do? I can't tip the cap to you. That's worth like a pound of gold or something. You know, there's actually a small town in southern Wyoming. If I tip my cap, they get like a better APR on their business plan. That's helpful, I mean. Anyways, y'all been a good bunch of folks. I'm just going to go spend the rest of my money. Keep on speaking to folks like you. And I don't know, I guess I'm just injured my penis or something.
No?
I don't know. I'm still in the middle of all this stuff. All right, have a good night.
Cowboy Cotton, John Cotton, everybody. There was just something so sexy about him. I felt a little inspired to bring you a little more cowboy porn. Would that be okay? Caught up in the moment, I placed my left hand on the back of the chief's head and forced him down on my cock. Without losing his rhythm on my dick, he immediately released my sack and raised his hand in the air. I understood my mistake when I saw movement out of the corner of my eye. The warrior on my right had drawn back his arrow, prepared to send it into my flesh. Apparently, I crossed some unseen line of Apache sexual etiquette. I quickly removed my hand, but the chief grabbed it and placed it on the back of his head once more. He seemed to welcome it and didn't pause in his sucking as my fear quickly dissipated and my fingers boldly found a grip in his wild, night black hair. I bucked like a bronc as I flooded the chief's mouth with my cream. That's a good place to stop. I'm going to be waiting to see what happens with that cream. I don't know what he does with that cream. That's crazy. Ladies and gentlemen. Oh, you want your hat back, sorry. Sorry. I appreciate it. All right.